Welcome to Brainstorm MTG. I'm ELD, and this is Fast Effect Double Speed Magic the Gathering from ELD's Time Vault Games in Bellingham, Mass. We have Brass Man on Brass City Vault, a new workshop deck. We'll see how this uses Karn the Great Creator, and DJ on Blue Moon, leading out with a basic island into Ponder. Not the type of start many people would associate with Vintage, but it is often solid enough. A little bit of card selection, getting the ball rolling. Mox Ruby and pass. Ancient Tomb and two Moxes into Karn. That gets Snap, Force of Willed, pitching Treasure Cruise. Powerful blue card going away. Blood Moon on the other side now, turning that Ancient Tomb and that Wasteland both into Mountains. Brassman still with access to four mana. See what he does with it. Phyrexian Revoker. Hitting Mox Ruby. And another Revoker. Now Snapcaster. Flashing back Ponder. That Scalding Tarn now tapping for red mana. And Snapcaster, a pretty reasonable answer to Revoker. Walking Ballista looking to take over the board, but that gets Force of Willed, so DJ with multiple forces here. Not usually great versus workshops. We'll see if this attrition holds up. Revoker goes down, a Revoker replaces it, also naming Mox Ruby. Beating down with Revoker. Ballista now making the type of small ball from cards like Snapcaster much less attractive. Another mountain, a very expensive mountain joining the board. And here mana draining a additional Walking Ballista. This is going to find a Vendilion Click. Putting Dak into the graveyard. Putting Dak onto the bottom. And just ending up with a concession there. Dak Thaden, another option, could have looted with him. That may have actually been what happened. It was a little unclear at the end. Either way, DJ was attempting to draw into some type of answer, unable to find it. And Brassman swarms through with both Phyrexian Revokers and Walking Ballista. The additional damage from Ballista proving to be pretty solid. Normally a card like Dak could come down and steal a threat, at least creating a 2-for-1 situation. Walking Ballista preventing that. Brassman up a game here. See if DJ can force a game 3. DJ playing cards like Narset, which are certainly much better versus decks that are going to be trying to draw a lot of cards. Very little impact versus workshops without additional pieces from Blue Moon. A card like Time Twister with Narset out can function as a sort of mind twist, allowing them to draw one card while you draw 7. Brassman, easy mulligan. It looks like DJ's gonna stay pat. A lot of fast mana here with nothing to do. Scrying. Hoping the top of the deck will give some type of explosive start. Preordain. No Sirs, both of those draws a fresh card. We've got Wasteland into Soul Ring. Grim Monolith. Nice gold border there. World Championship decks. Kai Bud's Wildfire deck. Hugely popular in the late 90s. Really opened a lot of people's eyes, myself included, to a whole new power level in Magic as a casual player back then. It was a real interesting thing to be able to see some quality deck building. Of course, this is well before the internet or things like YouTube were a mainstream part of Magic. Nullrod shutting things down for both sides in theory, but I've got a feeling DJ probably gonna be mostly okay with this effect. He's looking to rely on basic lands to build his mana base, even running Blood Moon, Ancestral, recouping some card advantage, and yet another basic land. Workshop and passing here for Brassman, so still nothing really worth doing in his hand. That Wasteland not likely to have a target. Ensnaring Bridge. And that gets mana drained. DJ likely having some type of immediate plan. Trinisphere for Brassman. He's going to hope to throw a little bit of a kink in whatever DJ was planning to do. A Braid on the Trinisphere with the drain mana. One left floating. Plus an additional land for Jace the Mind Sculptor. And he's actually brainstorming here. Feels like a reasonable time to start Fate Sealing. Let's see what he does. And Brassman actually packing it in there. Gonna go to game three. Did not want to try and fight through that Jace the Mind Sculptor. Perhaps a tad early on the concession. We'll see if this pays off for him on the play. Gonna hope for a very fast start. Can be difficult for opponents sometimes if you do concede early and then get off on a really fast start. Sometimes they'll have it in their head that you've made a mistake and they deserve to win. Very easy for them to get overconfident or kind of be caught up in the last game in those early turns. So Brassman would do well to get a quick start here and leave it for DJ to make an error, which Workshops does punish quite severely. I will say DJ's deck does look like it plays fairly smooth. I mean, you're talking about kind of consistent mana building with basic lands. One of the fairer things that I've seen in Vintage in quite some time. Workshop, Lotus, talk about fair. How about, is this going to be 7 mana on the first turn? Oh, just 6? Oh no. Let's make it 9 mana on the first turn, potentially. 2 workshop mana floating. That's going to power a Trinisphere, or sorry, a Sphere of Resistance. DJ will have nothing to say about any further cards this turn. What can he do with 7 mana? No, so he's going to Force of Will the Sphere of Resistance. Seven mana, just all in on a Walking Ballista. A little confusion there with the Mox Opal. Does actually not need to be tapped. Nullrod. So that Walking Ballista, just a 3/3 right now. Not hugely impressive. Nullrod doing a lot of work here. Everyone's been so hyped up about the new Karn. A Walking Ballista for one now. Workshop only going to be able to make X equals one. That Opal not able to help thanks to the Nullrod. And beatdowns, Snapcaster Mage. Just an Ambush Viper. Doesn't look like, yeah, no value. In a Trinisphere now. And this is getting very dangerous here for DJ. Let's see if he can find a way to stabilize. Ancestral Recall at 2 mana. Making another land drop and passing. Just 2 turns from death here. Fetch lands can complicate the situation. Down to 4. And a 5 mana Jace the Mind Sculptor bouncing the Walking Ballista. Is Ballista going to come back down as a 1-1? It does. Jace can afford to Fate Seal. Oh, a Braid taking that Ballista out. And a Brainstorm. Fear Resistance, its intention is to stop that type of cantripping from happening. Shutting down cards like Preordain and Ponder, making them cost 2 mana is a horrible deal. But Jace the Mind Sculptor, his Brainstorm is always 0 and always a bargain. It'll just be a question of when does he start Fate Sealing, or is he going to get a different win condition down and just back it up with card advantage? As you can see, DJ at just 3 life, he was 1 swing away from death from that Walking Ballista. Jace just in time. Blood Moon now means those workshops are now mountains. Brassman sitting on just 3 mana with a Sphere of Resistance in play. Pretty devastating situation. Fate Sealing happening. And this will likely be a wrap soon. Another Sphere of Resistance. Now he can only play 1 mana spells. And he's actually going to snap a Braid that. Or Braid the other Sphere. Bouncing Snapcaster with Jace. Perhaps just a value play for the Ancestral Recall. And Brassman gonna call it there. Convinced that Jace will eventually end the deal. So close, but Null Rod eliminating any type of reach that a Walking Ballista might have. And DJ taking it down and becoming the ELD Vintage Open Champion. Congratulations.